circulatory system, which is to be learnt properly. You don't have to understand anything here. Pulse, okay? You know that when ventricular systole occurs, the blood is forced into the arteries with high pressure, okay? Therefore, arteries will expand. And when there is diastole, because at that time the blood is not forced, therefore that expansion will be nullified now. What does it mean? The elastic recoil power of artery will come into the action, and the elastic, and because of that, the artery will resume its diameter. It will expand and again it will contract. This rhythmic expansion and contraction of the artery is going to be experienced in the superficial artery, okay, which is one of the artery that we have in the wrist, that is radial artery, and that is called as pulse. Pulse is the alternate expansion and elastic recoil of the arteries, usually felt in the wrist when you touch the radial artery, due to systole and diastole of the ventricles, left ventricle especially. The pulse rate per minute indicates the rate of the heart. The pulse rate per minute will indicate heart rate. And it is, for a normal person, it is 72 per minute. Okay, it is 72 per minute heart rate. Okay, any question regarding pulse? Arteries. Okay. That is what we are talking about. It is blood pressure. The force or the pressure with which blood flows in the blood vessel, especially arteries, is called as blood pressure. There are two limits of this pressure. There are two limits. The upper limit is called as systolic pressure. When heart contracts, that is during ventricular systole, and pushes blood into the arteries, it is called the systolic pressure, and that pressure will be always highest. It ranges from 100 to TO2 to 120 millimeter of mercury. That is systolic pressure, the higher pressure. Okay? Understood? Systolic pressure will always be higher because at that time blood is pushed inside the artery. And that will occur only when ventricular systole will take place. During ventricular systole, blood is forced into the aorta, and the artery receives blood under high pressure. That pressure will be called as systolic pressure. Okay? Now the second limit is the lower limit. That will be always diastolic pressure. Okay? When heart relaxes, that is when ventricular diastole takes place, the artery has less. Because during that time, ventricles are relaxing and atria are contracting, so more blood is coming to the ventricle. So at that time, arteries do not receive blood. So that is a time when there is less pressure in the artery. Okay, it ranges from 60 to 80 millimeter of mercury. Okay, that is called as diastolic pressure. Okay, in young adults, that is 60 to 60. What happened to Anshpreet? Sphygmomanomas. an instrument to measure blood pressure. You have to tie it down if you have any problem, otherwise you put your hand down. Hypertension or high blood pressure is when BP exceeds 140 systolic and 90 millimeter of mercury, then it is called as higher BP or hypertension. It occurs due to unbalanced diet, excessive work pressure and mental tension like anxiety, emotion, etc. or in old age due to reduced lumen of the arteries. Diastole is the condition. Diastole is the condition when the chambers of the heart are in relaxed condition. Okay. When the pressure of the blood will be high, that means the lumen of the artery is narrow. When the lumen of the artery will be narrow, then little pressure, then the blood received by the heart muscle will also be less. Sometimes there might be blockage because of that deposition of substances or thickening of the arteries, which will cause myocardial infarction or heart attack. Have you understood? Have you understood? You have to imagine a pipe. A pipe in the lumen of which, on the wall of which, something has, or the salt of the water has deposited. What will happen? Same thing happens in the blood vessel also, especially artery. The blood vessel will get the endothelial layer will get deposited with cholesterol or some other fat-like substances, and the artery will become narrow. The lumen will become very small. So the blood pressure there will increase, although it will be supplying less of the blood. Okay. Now we'll talk about the blood in general. What do you know about the blood? What do you know about the blood? Type one by one. Pratham, we have done it last time. When the cuspid walls shut down, then we hear the first heart sound that is called as lymph. And when semilunar wall, when semilunar wall shut down, then we get to hear the second heart sound, which is known as dub. Yes. Now listen to me.
Hello.
Blood is a fluid connective tissue. We call it as a connective tissue. Yes. Normal blood volume for adult ranges from 5 to 6 liters. That is normal volume of the blood. Blood is slightly alkaline. Blood is slightly alkaline. Its pH is 7.3 to 7.45. Let me speak. No, I don't want need answer from you all. Listen to me. Any point that is not clear, you are going to ask me then and there. Specific gravity of blood is 1.06 or 1.05. It ranges from 1.05 to 1.06. When oxygenated, blood is the dark red in color. Okay? Dark red or bright red in color. When deoxygenated, it is dull red in color. So, in artery, we find it bright red. In vein, we find it dull red. Liquid part of the blood is called as plasma. While in the plasma, the cellular part of the blood, that is blood corpuscle, remain suspended. So it is the plasma which happens to do maximum of the work of transport. Transporting one and everything is done with the help of plasma, because that is the liquid portion of the blood. Most of the thing remain dissolved in the plasma, in the water part of the plasma. Okay, now we'll see plasma first. Blood is, there will be a chart which I'm going to post it with the notes afterward. It will make you easier to learn the part of the blood. Now we'll talk about the plasma. It makes about 55 to 60% of the total blood volume. Plasma makes 55 to 60% of the total blood volume. It is transparent, alkaline, strong or pale colored liquid. It consists of, this part I will give. Structure and function of the heart I will not give. It consists of making the blood hypertonic. It consists of 90 to 92% of water, while 6 to 8% of plasma contain proteins. Okay, so water plus plasma protein makes the total plasma. Main plasma protein are the clotting protein. Clotting protein are fibrinogen and prothrombin. Then there is another protein known as albumin. Okay, the function of albumin is to maintain osmotic plasma. Then we have globulin. Globulin is protein which acts as antibody and helps in defense mechanism of the body. Inorganic salt are 1 to 2% and they include chloride, bicarbonate and phosphate of sodium, potassium and calcium. Okay? Then dissolved nutrients like glucose, fatty acid, vitamins and amino acid are present in blood. Hormones as chemical growth regulator are present. Dissolved gases, oxygen, carbon dioxide are present. Enzyme are present and excretory substances like ammonia, urea and creatinine, beside other metabolic waste, are also present in the plasma. Okay, function of plasma is to transport respiratory gases, nutrients, hormones. Okay, it also helps in the removal of excretory material. The other function of the plasma is protection. Protection by regulation of body temperature. It regulates body temperature. It helps in clotting of the blood and it helps in maintaining pH of the blood. Now we'll talk about blood corpuscles. These things you'll have to learn. Okay. Blood corpuscles are formed elements of the blood. They are formed elements of the blood. Okay. Which remain suspended in the plasma. Which are present in the plasma, which is having 90 to 92% of water. So these are suspended particles in the suspended cells in the plasma, blood corpuscles. These are cellular element or part of the blood. We'll start with the first one, RBC. RBC is pH. You have not gone in chemistry through it in 9. Hydrogen ion concentration. pH. You have done in chemistry, pH scale, where 7 is neutral, below 7 is acidic condition. Then above 7 is alkaline. So plasma maintains pH of the blood. We were talking about RBC. What do you know about RBC? That is it. You are not able to follow me what I am saying from this end? Hello? RBC is also known as erythrocyte. Okay, it's a small, circular, biconcave, disc-like structure. They are circular, biconcave, disc-like structure, measuring about 8 millimicron in diameter and 2 millimicron in thickness. Their biconcave area provides more surface area for more diffusion of oxygen and carbon dioxide. That is why, from evolution point of view, if you see, RBC when produced, when they originate from bone marrow, they have nucleus. But slowly as they mature, their nucleus is lost. They become enucleated. Now this enucleated condition make them to receive higher surface area. Now why do they need more surface area? So that diffusion of oxygen and carbon dioxide can take place at rapid rate. Okay? For diffusion of more gas. You know that RBC do not have, or it has lost some organelles. What are the organelles that are lost by RBC? It is mitochondria, it is endoplasmic reticulum, it is Golgi bodies. They are lost. Why are they lost? First of all, it increases motility of RBC. When these organelles are lost by a cell, the cell will automatically become light. So, it will increase motility of the cell. Is it clear? So that with the pressure of the blood by which it is forced into the artery, RBC can move or corpuscles can move. RBC can reach to the required organ fast. Therefore, its motility increases. When mitochondria is lost, RBC will become a faithful servant of your body by not using oxygen that it has to convey to the different organs, different cells of the body. So mitochondria, absence of mitochondria will be for 100% transportation of oxygen to the other cells of the body. RBC will not use oxygen for itself. Okay? So thereby concave area provides more surface area for more diffusion of oxygen and carbon dioxide. In adult male, RBC count is about 5 million per cubic millimeter of blood, while in female it is 4.5 per cubic millimeter of blood. RBC count may increase under the condition of hypoxia. What is hypoxia? When the concentration of oxygen is low, the condition is said to be hypoxia. Okay? When in the environment, concentration of oxygen, yes, deficiency of oxygen takes place, or concentration of the oxygen is low, as encountered by hilly individual, the person who are residing in hill, air pressure become less, the number of the oxygen concentration also decreases there. So what will happen? The count of RBC in their case will increase, so that whatever oxygen is available, RBC is going to take up and transport it. So number of RBC will increase in them. That is why their cheeks are red, rosy cheeks. Okay, so RBC count may increase under the condition of hypoxia on increased demand of oxygen by the body. The increased amount of RBC in body is called as polycythemia and is responsible for the rosy cheeks of the people on hill. The decreased amount of RBC is called as anemia. Mature RBC is enucleated. What do you mean by enucleated? What is enucleated? Yes, no nucleus. It doesn't have, or without nucleus is enucleated. Yes, very good. In mammals, including man, which allows RBC to become biconcave, RBC also is devoid of mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi body, which allows more area for accommodation of hemoglobin. Lack of mitochondria prevents use of oxygen by RBC itself. It also increases motility of RBC. Individual RBC is pale in color, but it is pale in color due to the presence of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a respiratory pigment containing an iron part called heme, which is conjugated or which is added with protein globin. Alright? Hemoglobin is a conjugated protein where a part is made up of iron and the other part is made up of protein known as globin. One molecule of hemoglobin can carry 4 molecules of oxygen. This you will have to remember. One molecule of hemoglobin can carry 4 molecules of oxygen. Hemoglobin combines reversibly with oxygen to give oxyhemoglobin. You have to mark the term reversibly. Hemoglobin also have affinity, little affinity for carbon dioxide, with which it combines reversibly to form carbaminohemoglobin. Okay, so hemoglobin, Hb plus CO2, sign of reversibility, HbCO2. Now this HbCO2 is called as carbaminohemoglobin. Okay, Hemoglobin has got immense affinity for carbon monoxide, with which it combines to give, with which it combines irreversibly. Once hemoglobin combines with carbon monoxide to form carbonyl compound, that reaction is not reversible. It is irreversible reaction. Then it forms carboxyhemoglobin. Okay? You have to make difference. You should be very clear from the beginning with the term carbaminohemoglobin and carboxyhemoglobin. Okay? Carbaminohemoglobin is combination with carbon dioxide. Carboxyhemoglobin is carbon monoxide. Okay? Normal adults have 15 gram of hemoglobin per 100 ml of blood. We'll still have to talk about erythrocyte. You have to remember the term erythropoiesis. Erythropoiesis is formation of erythrocyte. Erythropoiesis is formation of erythrocyte or formation of RBC. In embryo, it occurs in liver and spleen, erythropoiesis. Okay? While in adult, it occurs in red bone marrow of long bones, like humerus, femur, etc. Okay? There, erythropoiesis takes place. Lifespan of RBC, average lifespan of RBC is 120 days. Old, injured, and weak RBC are destroyed or disintegrated in spleen. A little is disintegrated in liver also. Okay? Spleen is referred as graveyard as well as reservoir of RBC, blood bank as well as graveyard of RBC. Destruction of RBC or disintegration of RBC produces bile pigments, bilirubin and biliverdin. Okay? Hemolysis is breakdown of RBC. Now, let us see function of RBC is transportation of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay? Now, quickly, what the mistake that you do in RBC? What is the function of RBC? 120 days. What is the function of RBC? To transport respiratory gases. Clear? To transport respiratory gas. Okay. What is the function of hemoglobin? What is the location and function of hemoglobin? In RBC. Yes. The stroma of RBC is filled with no Cushy. Listen, RBC as a biconcave disc-like structure whose diameter is 7 to 8 mm, thickness is 2 mm. The part from where nucleus is lost is only 1 mm. So central part of the RBC is 1 μm, okay, while the corners are of 2 μm. So here there is a depression, which is shown here in dark in color. Alright, this increases the entire RBC is filled with hemoglobin. The cytoplasm of RBC is nothing but hemoglobin, which carries oxygen. Okay? Now we'll start with leukocyte. The meaning of leuko is white. Okay? Therefore, they are also known as white blood cells. They do not contain any pigment. And they are always nucleated. Okay? So what is the first difference between RBC and WBC? RBC is, it contains the respiratory pigment hemoglobin. WBC do not contain. RBC do not have nucleus. When mature, WBC will retain their nucleus till their death. Okay? So WBC lack pigment and are colorless. They are nucleated and they are mostly amoeboid. When do you call a structure as amoeboid structure? Answer. When do you call a structure as amoeboid structure? You call it as amoeboid structure. Alright? Yes. Now, they are capable of squeezing out of the wall of blood capillaries with the help of pseudopodia, that is, they perform diapedesis. Alright? They perform diapedesis. Are you able to see the diagram? This is a blood capillary. Red color blood capillary with different type of cells, corpuscles. Okay, RBC, blood platelet, WBC. Now, blood capillary is within the skin. This is the first skin is first line of defense. Suppose first line of defense in the body is has got a cut. Through this cut, microorganism can enter the body. Okay? When microorganism enter the body, then they produce toxins. Toxins are nothing but chemicals. Therefore, chemotaxis occur because of the attraction by the chemical. WBC will be attracted. Now, what type of WBC will be attracted? The one which has the amoeboid chain. Mainly, we'll come to know about it later, neutrophils, monocytes. They are helpful in removing toxins from the body of the organism, individual. So, they come to the wall of the blood capillary, near the wall of the blood capillary, where there is attack from outside. Now they squeeze out because they can throw pseudopodia. Okay, this is squeezing out of WBC, out of the wall of blood capillary. That is why blood capillary is single layer thick. Okay? This process is called as diapedesis. Now there will be a fight between enemy and the soldier. Soldier is WBC. Enemies are microorganism or their toxin. Now, Samad, we'll all join Samad for the class. WBC that will be coming out. There will be number of WBC that will be coming out of the wall of the blood capillary. So when number of WBC come out, there will be a fight between them, and as a result, if WBC is going to win, you are not going to show any symptom of disease. But if the toxin wins, you are going to show the symptom of the disease. If your WBC is going to win, they are of course going to die while combating the enemy. So there will be an inflammation. Inflammation is swelling, local swelling. Okay, this swelling may have little pus in it. This will be called as inflammation, and here pus or debris that is left by the interaction between the toxins or the microorganism and the WBC. There will be dead microorganism, dead WBC here. That will be pus. So pus is a sign of defense mechanism. Abscess is pus only. An inflammation carrying pus. Okay, that is inflammation. Now eating up of toxins or microorganism by WBC is called as phagocytosis. So first there will be injury, then there will be diapedesis. This will be followed by phagocytosis. If you get a jumbled terms, then injury will be first, then followed by diapedesis, and then phagocytosis. Here, this is one of the very important function of WBC. Okay? So, a normal adult have 6,000 to 8,000 WBC per cubic millimeter of blood. Increase in number of WBC is called as leukocytosis, while increase in number of WBC at the cost of RBC, then only you show the symptom of disease. Okay, it's at the cost of, if your immune system will not be strong, you won't be able to fight. Toxin will win there. And then you will be having fever. You have to get it removed or it gets diffused like excretory material. Of RBC is called as leukemia. Decrease in number of WBC is called as leukopenia. Leukopoiesis is formation of WBC in the bone marrow. Leukopoiesis also occur in lymph node. Do you remember I told you lymph node adds lymphocytes? So leukopoiesis also occur in, besides bone marrow, it also occur in lymph nodes. Lifespan of WBC is 2 weeks. Two types of WBC are there. The two types of WBC are granulocyte and agranulocyte. Granulocytes have granules in the cytoplasm and they have lobed nucleus. Agranulocytes have no granule in their cytoplasm and they have, their nucleus is not lobed. Okay? They will have lobed nucleus. They will not have lobed nucleus. They have granules in the cytoplasm which can stain, which can be stained by various types of stain and according to which their name has been assigned. Okay, there are three types of granulocytes: neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil. Neutrophil, it is so called because of the granulocytes. They have granules in the cytoplasm and they have lobulated nucleus and therefore they are called as polymorphonuclear leukocyte. Okay? In short, they are called as PMNL, polymorphonuclear leukocyte. They are also called as polymorph. Okay, we'll start with neutrophil. Neutrophil are soldiers of your body and they are maximum in number. They are around 50 to 60% of total leukocyte count. Okay, they are stained with neutral dyes or with a mixture of acidic and basic dye. Alright, neutrophil. Their cytoplasm has fine granule and their nucleus has 3 to 4 lobes. Okay, this is neutrophil. You can see they are mainly amoeboid. They don't have a fixed shape. And the nucleus has got 3 to 4 lobes. And cytoplasm has got fine granules. And these granules are, they take stain by neutral dye. Okay? They are very motile, actively motile and phagocytic. That is, they can do diapedesis as well as phagocytosis. Their life is around 10 to 12 hours. Okay? Now, followed by neutrophil is eosinophil. You can see the shape of granule there. Granule is rough or coarse. And the nucleus has got 2 lobes in eosinophil. Here, the number increases during allergy. If there is allergy in your body, their number will definitely increase. And the condition is called as eosinophilia. Okay, they are around 1 to 5% of total leukocyte count. They have important role in immunity and allergy. Okay, the third and the last is basophils. Basophils are stained with basic dye. Eosinophils are stained, the granules here are stained by acidic dye which is eosin. Here it is stained by basic dye which is methylene blue. Okay, the granule here are lesser in number and more rough in comparison to eosinophil. Okay, they release heparin. Heparin is an anticoagulant. It will not allow blood to clot. Okay, so these releases, basophil releases heparin in blood. Okay? And they also release histamine, a vasodilator. It dilates the vessel. What will happen when the blood vessel will be dilated? The wall will become thin. Diapedesis will become easier. Okay, then only neutrophil will be leaving the blood capillary to fight with the toxins or microorganism. Life of basophil is 8 to 12 hours. Alright, now we'll start with agranulocyte. There are only 2 agranulocytes. The first one is lymphocyte. Here you can see the nucleus is large. Lymphocyte is the smallest WBC. The nucleus is large and it is eccentric. Eccentric towards one side of the cell. And you can see very little layer of, very small layer of cytoplasm is present. Okay, the shaded is nucleus and just a lining of cytoplasm is present in lymphocyte. Lymphocyte has got very important role to play in immunity as it produces antibodies. Okay, alright. Monocyte is the largest WBC and the nucleus is horseshoe shape or it has got a little dent. Okay, horseshoe shape or kidney shape nucleus is there and you can see cytoplasm without granule. This is how you have to make in your practical file. I'll send you the diagram. Okay. Agranulocyte, leukocyte lack granules in their cytoplasm. Their nucleus is without lobe. Lymphocyte are smallest of WBC. They have round and eccentrically placed nucleus. They produce antibodies. They are 25 to 30% of TLC. They are non-motile and non-phagocytic. Next is monocyte, our largest of WBC. They are produced in liver and thymus and bone marrow. They have kidney-shaped nucleus and they do phagocytosis. They remove dead cell and debris. Now blood platelets. Blood platelets are cytoplasmic fragments. They do not have nucleus. Okay? They are produced in the bone marrow by giant cell. Giant cell which is called as megakaryocyte. Ingest is taking it, digest is digesting it. Okay? These are cytoplasmic fragments. See? They will appear like this, lymphocyte. They have got very important role in clotting of the blood. Injured tissue, these are blood platelets. Blood platelets of injured tissue releases thromboplastin, which will react with prothrombin, which is soluble, and calcium ion to make thrombin. Okay? This thrombin is going to react with fibrinogen, which is again soluble protein, to get with the help of calcium ion to convert it into insoluble fibrin. Fibrin is going to make a network over the injured tissue. It makes a mesh-like thing to in which blood corpuscles are trapped. That is why clot appears red in color. Okay? It is because of the trapped RBC. Otherwise, fibrin is not red in color. It is because of the trapped RBC that the clot becomes red in color. After few minutes, the size of the clot becomes smaller. And when the size of this becomes smaller, liquid part of the blood, which is devoid of fibrinogen, oozes out, which is called as serum. S-E-R-U-M. This serum protects the injured area from infection. That is a function of serum. It helps in protection of injured area from infection. Okay. That complete circulatory system. Now, blood transfusion and blood group is left. Now, let me know if you can do it yourself. Blood group and blood transfusion. Can you do it yourself? I will just quickly revise when we meet next. And we'll start the last chapter of our half yearly syllabus. Okay? Have you understood what I have told you today? Now start doing the question that is at the back of the lesson. And if you have any problem, you can ask in the group. You can put the question in the group. All right? Thank you. Same to you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.